In today's tutorial, we are going to look at how we can add 3D objects into a photo in After Effects. First of all, it's a lot easier to motion track a video and extract the 3D data. But what would you do if you have a still image or you film the scene using a tripod? You could try and match the camera by moving and rotating the camera in After Effects manually, but you would end up spending a lot of time and still won't get the perspective right or the precise focal length of the camera. I'm gonna show you a few tricks to match the camera position, orientation, and the approximate focal length. For this, we need a software called fSpy, a After Effects script that helps us import the data into After Effects, and Element 3D to add the 3D objects into our scene. The download links to everything you need to complete this tutorial is in the description. Now let's go. First, let's import a photo or static footage into a new composition. In this tutorial, I'm gonna use a picture of a living room. Let's adjust the composition size to the size that you want the output to be. I will make my output video a full HD. Now we can scale and move the still image around until we're satisfied with our scene. Let's save this frame, so let's go to Composition, Save Frame As, File, save it as a JPEG sequence, press OK, and we can save this file wherever we want. I'm gonna name this file New Room, and I'm gonna hit Render. And now it's time to download fSpy. Go to the link in the description and follow the link to download. Since we're in the process of downloading fSpy, go to the description and follow the link to my fSpy importer for After Effects script. It is free, but if you like it, you can type in the value that you feel this script is worth. Now you can download the script and save it wherever you want. Once fSpy is installed, run it, go to File, Open Image, and select our new room image that we rendered out from After Effects. The first thing we have to specify is the vanishing point axis. Set the first one to minus Z and the second one to minus X. Check the box for rectangle mode. Now we get two blue lines and two red lines. Let's move the lines around and create a plane. The red lines should run along the wall and the blue line should run along the sofa, like so. You can uncheck the dim image checkbox for more visibility. Let's adjust the points like so. To get a sense of the perspective, we could select a 3D guide. And here we can choose the XZ grid floor. Now it's easier to see where the floor is located. Let's dim the image once more. Make sure that the Y axis is pointing upwards, the X axis to the right, and the Z axis is pointing towards you. Now we can move this plane around to see if we got the perspective right. Let's adjust this corner right here and see if the plane aligns with the sofa and the wall over here. Okay, I think this looks good. Now we have to export the camera data, so let's go to File, Export, and choose Camera Parameters as JSON. Let's save this file as New Room Camera. Press Save. And now we're done in fSpy. Let's get back to After Effects. Back in After Effects, and we're gonna use the script to import the camera parameters from fSpy. Go to File, Scripts, Run Script File, and select the fSpy importer for After Effects script. The script is now running, but before we move on, I would like to give a shout out to Peter and Pat for helping me out with the programming of my first After Effects script. I would also like to mention the YouTube channel NT Productions for providing well-explained extend script tutorials. Go give him some love at his channel. And if you have trouble with my script or have feedback that you would like to share, please do it in the comment section. Anyway, click open and select our new room camera JSON file. Click Create Camera. This will automatically create a solid that represents the ground and a camera with the same camera parameters that we got from fSpy. We can close the script now. And as we move this solid around, we can see that it moves along with the perspective of the scene. Now it's time to add a 3D model into our scene, and we're gonna use Element 3D plugin from Video Copilot to do it. So we're gonna create a new solid, call it E3D, press OK. I'm gonna drag the Element 3D plugin onto it. Before going into the scene setup, we're gonna add the photo as a texture map, because we're gonna use our scene as the environment map to get a more realistic result. So go to Custom Layers, Custom Texture Maps, and select the living room photo as layer 1. Once this is done, we can go to the scene setup. In the scene setup, click Environment, choose layer 1 and press OK. And now we can import our 3D model. Click Import and select the Elephant 3D model that came with the project file. Download link in the description. Press OK. Check the normalized size so we get the scale right. Shift the camera to left view and move the 3D model above the positive value of the Y axis. And center it. Switch back to perspective. And now we can play around with the textures. Uncheck the draft textures right here. Let's go inside the materials here and select elephant skin. And just for fun, let's change the diffuse color to something crazy like pink. Increase the diffuse. 2.5 maybe. Now we can decrease the glossiness to 0. And decrease the environmental multiplier to, I don't know, 30 maybe. All right, we're done. Press OK. All right, nice. Now we have a pink elephant in the room. It's a little bit big, so let's scale this down a little bit. Go to group 1, particle look. Let's scale it down. Let's move the elephant to the side here. And remember not to move the elephant in the y-axis, because the value of the y-axis, 540, is the level of the ground. Let's move it in the z-axis as well. Let's move it to the right here. We can rotate the elephant as well. Let's have him stand like this. And now we can go down and hide the ground solid. As we can see right now, the lighting isn't realistic because we have windows here and we have shadows here on the elephant. So we're gonna create new lights. Left click and create new light. Let's name this light window light. We can set the intensity to 250. Cone angle 90 degrees, cone feather 10%, and this one is really important, that the light casts shadows. We can leave the shadow darkness at 115%. I'm gonna press OK. Now we have to place the light source where the windows are in our scene. Let's hit P for the light and hit P for the ground solid. And now we want to copy the position of the ground solid to the position of the light. So we're gonna press Ctrl C, Ctrl V. So now we're gonna move in the X direction so the light lines up somewhere where the wall begins. And then we're gonna move it up in the Y axis so it has the same level as the windows. It's really important that we move the light in one axis at a time so we don't mess up the position of the light in the 3D space. Let's switch the camera position to top view and rotate the light so it points at the elephant. Let's switch back to active camera view. And let's duplicate this light, Control D, and move it in the Z axis so the light represents the second window. It's a little bit bright here, so we can decrease the light a little bit. Like so. Now the elephant is a little bit dark in the shadow parts here, so go to Element 3D plugin and go to Render Settings, Physical Environment, and increase the exposure. To make this scene a little bit more realistic, we can add shadows. So let's go to Scene Setup. Let's create a plane. Let's scale this up. way up like this. And for the material settings for this plane, we're gonna scroll down and we're gonna check this box here. Wait. Matte shadows. Now the plane disappears, but that's all right. We're gonna click OK. And now nothing happens, so let's go back to render settings and go to shadows. And let's enable shadows. And now we can see that the elephant is casting shadows here. Let's increase the blur radius to 20 maybe. Now the final thing that we want to do is to enable ambient occlusion. We can increase the intensity to 5, maybe a little bit less, 3 maybe. Now if the shadow is too dark, we can go down to output, multipass mixer, and decrease the opacity of the shadow, like so. Alright, awesome, we are done. I hope you liked this tutorial. Please leave me some feedback on the script that I wrote. I hope you learned something new today. See you in the next tutorial. Bye bye.